Hi, I'm a digital content ambassador and my name is Charlotte. In this video, I was going to talk about my 3 years at Lancaster and talk about some of my favourite highlights and memories from the past 3 years. I've been documenting so much of the past 3 years on social media, so I'll also be showing you some clips and photos from my time at Lancaster. So I moved into my campus accommodation in 2017 and I was in Pendle Ensuite. That accommodation is in Alexandra Park. I actually filmed a little video of when I was moving in and what it looked like. I spent most of the welcome week with my flat. We went to some of the college events. We also went into town. We went to the castle. We spent most of the week basically trying to get to know each other before our lecture started in week one. So throughout the first term, obviously I was settling in, but I managed to go to town to do my shopping. I used the on-campus laundry facilities. I spent time with my flat in the evening, but I also got to know people on my course as well. Towards the end of first term, I remember going to the Manchester Christmas Market with my friend, and I remember it was snowing all across the northwest, and that was like a good way to end first term before going home for Christmas. When I came back, second term was the same. Me and my flatmates discovered our love for Grisdale Bar. We would go there all the time to get cocktails. I also spent a lot of time with my course mates, whether we were doing hair dyeing or tree planting. We also went to a protest in the local community. We also celebrated people's birthdays. Now we knew each other a lot better, whether it was getting takeaways or going down to the lake to eat pizza. In third term, in first year we still had teaching, but we also had roses. I don't have a lot of footage from roses, but it was one of the best weekends I had at uni the whole time. I didn't take part in anything, but it was bank holiday weekend. It was so hot, it was so sunny. I watched quite a few different competitions and events, but that was genuinely one of the best weekends. After exams, I spent a lot of time with my friend. We explored town a little bit more. We discovered a place called Tipple that we really loved. And then at the end of the term, we had extravs, which is where each college organizes its own sort of outdoor event right at the end of term, and they all have themes where you can dress up, and this is a great way to sort of end the year with all the friends that I'd made in first year. Then at the end of June, we moved out of our flats, but some of my friends did actually come and visit me over the holidays as well from uni, so we didn't have too long without seeing each other. Also in August, I moved into my house in town, and I didn't move in there fully, but I did spend a few days getting to know town a lot better. I went to Williamson Park, I went to Lake Windermere in the Lake District on a day trip, I went to Manchester on a day trip, and then I also worked some open days as well in the summer. At the start of second year, I actually took up a role to help international students who would come to the university and help them, greet them from the coaches and to help get them moved in. I also took part in Freshers Fair, advertising my society. I also got a new job as digital content ambassador, which is what I'm still doing now, and I did my first Instagram story with my friend Tom. I was living with people from my course instead of my first year flatmates, but I still made sure that I kept in contact with them, and it was really fun when we had our own house. We could decorate it for Halloween and Christmas and stuff like that. Towards the end of first term, I also did my week in the life as a biology student video. That was right before Christmas. You can watch that on this channel. After the 4 week Christmas break, I came back, reunited with my friends, and we basically discovered a pub and restaurant in town called the Study Rooms. You'll see there's loads and loads of photos from the Study Rooms because it was one of our favorite places to go to get food, drinks, or to go to the pub quiz on a Thursday. Obviously, I was doing work throughout all of this. I don't have a lot of evidence of actually doing any work. Whether the weather was good or snowing, I was still in labs, in lectures, in workshops. I also helped to make some of the accommodation videos that are on this channel. I had so much fun with Javier and Paola editing those. And even when I was doing work, I was still making sure that I had loads of time to go out with my friends. Another place that we discovered we loved in town was a place called Hogarth. And towards the end of term, I also went on a trip to Glasgow by myself. That's about 2 hours away from Lancaster. And at the end of second term also is when nearly all my friends have their birthdays. So we celebrated their birthdays if we were doing surprise parties or going out. And I actually went to Sugar for the first time. I was really nervous about going in first year and my flat weren't really into going out. But then I finally pushed myself at the end of second term and I went for the first time. It's a students union club, so it's students only, and there's a free bus there and back from campus. But if you live in town, you can just walk there and back as well. So in second year, I had quite intense exams. So I spent a lot of time over Easter to revise and use the library during the holidays. but I also got to explore a few other places. I went to Morecambe, I went to the Loon Aqueduct and got to explore the area around my house where I was living in second year. But I spent most of the time throughout April and May studying whether it was raining or whether there was lovely weather. Obviously after exams, we all went out to celebrate whether we were going to Sugar or to the study room pub quiz. We actually won for the first time after going for weeks and weeks on end. And also I remember seeing the little ducklings on campus as well. After our exams, we had a little break, but then we actually started our dissertations. We had about 6 weeks in the lab working on independent research projects, which we then wrote up in third year. I also started running and I got to explore the area near my house even more. I found lots of cats and took photos every single time I saw any cats on the road. My friend Phil actually brought his mum's car up for a day or two and we went on a drive around the area, went to the Trough of Bowland, which we'd never been able to go to before, and just explored a lot of the areas around Lancaster. Me and my friends from first year, we also went on a trip to the Nando's in Preston as well, which is literally about 15 minutes away on the train. And we really used the end of term to discover new places like the Corner House, and we went on loads of nights out, and we also went on a trip to Manchester just to go to the Wagamamas as well. And then we ended second year in the same way, where we had extras where we got to dress up and celebrate with the sort of the end of year, making it through second year with all my friends from my course who I lived with from first year. And after extras, I also did another Instagram takeover working at the open day. I was sort of showing what was going on at the open day on Instagram. In the summer, instead of my friends visiting me, I went to visit some of my friends, which was really nice because I got to see where they live. Obviously the summer holiday is about 3 months long, and that's a long time to go without seeing your uni friends, so it's definitely worth making trips to go and see them. I celebrated my last freshers week in third year, and I spent a lot of first term in third year writing my dissertation, getting on top of all my work to make sure that this year I was gonna get the best grades that I possibly could. So I spent a lot of time doing work, but I also got to get out. Obviously I went to see Light of Lancaster, which happens in November. One of the things I saw was like a massive moon that they had in the church. Not really sure why it was there, but it was really cool. I also celebrated my birthday. It was a new Italian restaurant called Paolo Gianni's, and it was really aesthetically pleasing, so me and my friends took the opportunity to take loads of photos. A new place called Cantina had also opened that I went and explored with my friend Kasia, who had actually come back from her year abroad in second year, so it was so nice to have her back in Lancaster. We also had a Christmas meal at a restaurant called Goose Park, and me and some of my friends also made a Christmas meal at home. Two of us are vegetarian, so it was mostly a vegetarian Christmas meal, but it was still worth the effort. Right before Christmas as well, we had a bit of snow, we had some questionable weather, but still Christmas in Lancaster right before we leave is one of my favourite times. Everyone gets together and catches up with each other before going home for the holidays. Then I came back for term two, and there was lots of birthdays to celebrate and more restaurants and bars and pubs to discover. A couple times while being at Lancaster, they've brought dogs onto campus. They take advantage of the opportunity to go, and whether it's guide dogs or rescue dogs, to donate to the charities, and then you get to sort of stroke the dogs. It's really cute. My workload was a lot lighter, so I really took the opportunity to go on lots of nights out, whether it was with my friends that I always go out with. I went on some socials with Frisbee, as well as with Latin American Society, and even in third year, like, I still feel like you're always making friends all the time. I also did an Instagram takeover with Becky, and then me and Becky and Rachel made a video about our favourite spots on campus, and I had so much fun editing with those two. I also lived in a different house in third year near Williamson Park, so I had loads of trips up there, especially when it was a clear day and the view was amazing. And towards the end of term, I also went on my first and only field trip to the Lake District and to Lake Windermere. Even though my third term was cut short, I know that once things aren't as crazy, I'll definitely be going back up to say goodbye to a lot of my friends for the last time. And I know a lot of my friends will be staying in Lancaster for another year doing a master's. I know as soon as I can, I'll be going out to visit them, to be going back to Sugar, to go to Roses again, to extras, things like that, just to celebrate. So that was sort of a whistle-stop tour through some of my favourite memories and favourite things that I did whilst at university. Obviously so much has been missed out, including days and evenings that I spent in the library doing work and doing assignments, and just doing things like going around to my friend's house and like just chilling with them. Like, you wouldn't really have any photos or anything from it. I hope this video gives you some sort of insight in what it might be like to study at Lancaster. Obviously everyone has really different experiences, and if you have any questions or comments, you can leave them down below, as well as check out some of the videos that I've helped to make as a digital content ambassador. And I hope that you enjoy this video.